Hi, George here, and I'll be showing you how to make a custom texture pack. We're going to be changing the texture of that portal right back here, the obsidian on that portal. Now to do this, we'll be getting a new texture for that, and then putting that texture into a new resource pack, custom resource pack. Then we'll use that custom resource pack to change the texture here for all the obsidian in the game. Okay, the first thing we'll need for this is going to be a new texture. So let's take a look and see if we can find a nice new texture to put on that obsidian right there for our nether portal. And for that, let's switch over to the desktop. The first thing you need for your custom texture pack is a place to build that pack. And I have a folder here I called Bedrock Packs. It'll make it right inside here. We'll be getting all of this stuff. I'll show you where to get this. I'll just delete all of that. You can either use the vanilla pack icon right here. I'll show you where that is. Or you can make your own. I'll be using my own right here. Really easy. This is just a 128 by 128 PNG file. That's all that is. Nothing special about that. So if you want to make your own, that's fine. Got this from an online tool that works over in Java to make your own custom totems, and that included the pack PNG file. I'll put a link for that in the description if you want to see how to go ahead and use that to get the icon part of that. It takes a bit of extra work to use the custom totem inside of Bedrock, but I'll put a link for my video about how to do that as well. So I'll be using that custom totem. Now the next thing we need in here is going to be the original obsidian image, and for that we need to download the current vanilla resource pack for Bedrock. Let me show you where you can find that. And it's right here. I'll put this link in the description so you can click right to this page. Now you'll normally be seeing some preview things. Ignore those. Come down to where it says latest. That's the one you want to use. Right now we're in 1.19.70.2. And come down here and then click on the source code zip right there. And we'll then download this into our working folder. And it's right here. Again, I just made this on my hard drive. Just called it Bedrock Packs. Nothing special, just a new folder. Choose save, and we'll save it into that location. Okay, let's now go back to that folder again. There we go. Now we need to open this up in a new window. I'm just going to right-click, and let's open in new window right here. I'm on Windows 11 right now. If you're on Windows 10, this may be a bit different spot on your pop-up. But same thing, just open it in a new window. There we go. Now it'll say Bedrock Samples, and there are quite a few things inside here. Let's just go inside of this. And we want to go inside the one that says resource pack right here. And there are a few things you want from here. The first one is that pack icon PNG. If you want to use the vanilla PNG, that's what that is right here. I just renamed mine different. It wouldn't compete with this one, but that's all that is. If you want to use that, there you go. We also need this manifest.json file. Now we're inside of the zip. So just take this and just drag it over here. And it cups it out of the zip right here. There we go. Okay, now we need to get the obsidian texture. So go in here to textures and go up here to blocks and then find obsidian. And it's right here. Same thing, just drag it over there and drop it in. Now the obsidian came out of these folders up here. It came out of textures and blocks. So we need to make those folders. We'll get that out of the way right now. Go up to new, come down to folder. First one is textures. And then inside of textures, new folder, blocks. We'll be putting our new texture inside of that folder once we have that taken care of. Okay, so that's everything we need in here to build our resource pack. We'll come back to this, but right now let's go ahead and find a new texture to use for our obsidian. And that can also close that down. We're done with that. You can hang on to this if you want to. If you're going to be doing more things, keep this around, or you can just delete it. I'll just leave mine there in case I want to do more textures. Okay, now we need to find a new texture for obsidian. And we need a repeating pattern texture. And let me show you a website where you can go and do a search and find a lot of repeating textures that are free downloads. Let me bring that up. And this right here, it's called Pixabay. And again, I'll put this link in the description so you can just click there and get right to this page. Go over here where it says search, change this to illustrations. We're only searching for illustrations. And then let's do a search here for repeating pattern. And it's right there, repeating pattern. And here we go. Now, because we're working with blocks inside of Minecraft, only look at the repeating patterns that are square. Like this one right here is a square pattern. Those are no good. This is a square. That's okay. That's no good. That's a square. That's okay. That's a square. That's okay. So anything that's a square, that's kind of interesting. Anything that's a square pattern, that's fine to use. Let's just see what we have down here. That's kind of wacky. I kind of like that one. Let's come down a bit further here and see what we have. Okay, here's some strange monsters. I like the bright colors. It's a square image. When you look at one of these things, to double check, make sure that it's repeating, look at something on the right-hand side and see if it continues on the left-hand side. So here's our ice cream cone, and it's right over there, left-hand side. This is kind of a green thing with a little bit of stripes. Here we go, green thing, a little bit of stripes. So it's repeating left and right, that's fine. And then check top to bottom. Here's the top of a green thing right here, and there's that green thing. Okay, so this is definitely a repeating pattern. So click on this, and you can then download this for free. Now, I have an account here, but the account is free. No cost to that. It just makes it easier to download. If you don't have an account, you'll just get one of those captcha windows where you have to match pictures, one of those stupid things. It just slows you down, but that's all it is. It's still free download. So go over here where it says free download. You want the smallest one that they have. This is still too big for our use. We'll make it smaller, but go for the smallest one. And let's download that to our new working folder. Right here, resource packs, that's good. Choose save. And there we go, that's downloaded. We're done with that. And there's our new texture. Okay, now we need to make this a better size. This is too small, we'll lose detail. This is too big. What I normally do is I resize these things by doubling it each time. If I want just a little bit more detail, I want to keep my file size as small, I'll go to a 32 by 32. This one is 16 by 16 pixels. So if I want a bit more, I'll go 32 by 32, or my next up would be 64 by 64. Next up is 128 by 128, and next up is 256 by 256. And that's all we need here. That's a lot of detail, almost photorealistic at that size, and it's still a fairly small file size. It's not going to cause you any problems in the game. So we need to bring this down to that 256 by 256 image size. And for that, I have another free tool. It's an online image editor. Let me bring that up. And it's right here. It's called Pixlr. Now, this is a really good photo editor. It's a lot like Photoshop, not as powerful, but a lot like Photoshop. And you can do a lot of that real fancy stuff, but it also works out great here with Minecraft images. Now, there is a limit on the free stuff here. You can only download 3 times per day, but that's per day. So you can do a lot of downloads in a month, but 3 per day. Over here, it says start photo editing. If you like this thing and you want to do more, you can go ahead and get a premium account. That's at a couple of levels. One level, if you pay yearly, is only 75 cents a month. And the second level, if you pay yearly, is about $5 per month. That has all of the tools. The first one, though, 75 cents per month, that gives you unlimited downloads. So if you like using this thing, that's a great way to go. We'll go here, click on Advanced Photo Editor, bring this up. And you can see down here, I was using this for creating my pack icon right there. Okay, let's open image. And here we are inside of our working folder. We want our new texture. Open this up, and here we go. And all we need to do here is just to decrease the size of this. So for that, go up here to Page. Come down to Smart Resize. We're going to be scaling. You don't want smoothing. Uncheck that. You want to avoid stretching, so check this. So smoothing off, avoid stretching on. They'll keep your detail as good as possible. We're scaling this. And the width and height are locked. That's correct. So just change one of these to 256. The second one becomes 256. And that resizes our image. And we're all set for that. Okay. Choose Apply. And there's a resized image. It still looks real nice, real high quality detail in there. But it's a better size for use in Minecraft. Okay. Now go over here, right hand side, and come down. Little save button right here. Click on that to download. I want to download this as a PNG file. That's right here. Transparency doesn't matter since there's no transparency in this. You can just ignore that. Choose Save As. And we're back in our same location. Now you want to save this as the name of the original one. So click on that. It's also a PNG, but don't save it here. Go inside of Textures, go inside of Blocks, and save it right here. And choose Save. And that was one of my 3 daily free downloads. That's fine, just close that down. Okay, so we've taken care of that. We've now resized our texture. Now all we need to do is just to put that into a texture pack, put it into the game, and activate that pack. Easy stuff. Okay, let's just go back over here to our working folder. So we need our textures right here. We have our pack icon. We also have this manifest that we copied out of the zip file right here. We need to edit this just a little bit. Now I have mine opening up here in Notepad++, which is a free download again, and it's a great program for editing these kind of little code files. Let me show you that real quickly here. And the download's right here. I'll put this link in the description so you can go ahead and download this. Again, free download. Okay, let's open this up. Here we go. Reason I like this instead of other things like Notepad, is that the code is all colorized like this. We have line numbers over here. It makes it real easy to work with. Now, there are two things that we have to do in here. The first one is we want to change the description right up here. Let's call this one crazy pack. Or crazy texture pack. That works out fine. Let me just select that. Make sure you keep those two quotation marks in there. Very important. Right click and copy. I'll put that right here. Right click and paste. And I'll put it right down here as well. Right click and paste. That way, when we see it in our list of resource packs, we'll know what it is. The second thing we have to do is to change these UUID codes. There are two of them. There's one up here and there's one down here. These have to be different than this and different from each other. So we need two new UUID codes. These are basically license plates for the texture packs so that the game can tell the pack apart from different packs. That's all that is. And there's a website, again, a free website for getting new codes in here. Let me bring that up. And it's right here. And I'll put this link in the description as well, so you can go right to this page. You want this one here that says Online UUID Generator. We're in version 4. Let's come down here, click on Refresh. Gives you a new code. Click on Copy. Let's go back over and put it into the manifest file. So here we go. So select all of this code right here. Make sure you don't select those quotation marks. We want to be just inside the quotation marks. Right-click and paste. There's our first one. Let's do the same thing now for the second one. Let's go back over to that page. Here we go. Click on Refresh. There's a new one. Click Copy. Go back over to the manifest. Right here, let's just select this. Right-click and paste. There we go. We now have our two new codes. And that's all you have to do with the manifest JSON. Choose Save. And that's taken care of. Okay, that's really the pack is ready to go. So click on the textures folder, which has our new texture in it, has this thing inside the textures folder. Hold the control key down, grab that manifest.json, and grab your pack icon PNG, either a custom one like I'm using or the default one over there, which I showed you previously. So I have three things: texture, manifest, and pack icon. Right click on any one of these, doesn't matter. I'll do the middle one here and compress to zip file. We're doing this inside of Windows 11. Give it a name. I'll call it Crazy Texture. If you're working inside of Windows 10, then go to the top of the file window and left-hand side, click on the Share tab, and then you'll see the zip button right over there. Same exact thing. Now click into this a couple of times, slow. Don't click too fast. If you double-click, it's going to open it up. You don't want that. Just click once, click a second time. That takes you into the name like this. Let's go clear to the end. Just going to back up over that. And let's rename this mcpack. So crazytexture.mcpack. Click outside someplace. Click yes. And you should see that icon change into a Minecraft texture pack. If you don't see that, just go inside of a folder and come back out again. And it will reset or reread that window. So we're fine there. Okay, now to launch this thing, make sure that Minecraft is not running. So mine's right here. Let me just quit out of this. Close that, hit the escape key, and we'll exit Minecraft. Okay, so Minecraft is closed. Now double-click on your new resource pack. It's going to launch Minecraft and then load in that new resource pack. And we'll check this to make sure that it loads correctly. We'll see this upper left-hand corner. Okay, there we go. Import started. That's good. Give it a minute, and successfully imported Crazy Texture Pack. We're all set. That's now in the game. Okay, now we need to activate the pack. Come down to Settings. In Settings, scroll down here, go into Global Resources, go into My Packs, and you should see it right here. Here's our Crazy Texture Pack. That's why we renamed that inside the manifest so it gets spotted easily. Click on that. Click Activate. That should go up into Active. Let's double check. Here it is inside of Active, so that's good. Okay, it's back out of the Settings. We'll then load that into the game. And let's now play it and see how it looks. Click on Play. Here's the main world. Okay, so there's our new texture pack. Let's test this out and see how it looks inside the Nether. There's both sides of that. I think that's real fun. Before I go in the Nether, let me put on some armor in here. Make sure we're all suited up. Don't want to die just for this demo. Okay, back out of that. And let's test this out. Just hop inside here. Okay, we're inside the Nether. Fast look around, looks safe, we're gonna be okay. Okay, let's see how that looks. All right, that looks really great. Let's see how it looks from a distance. Just walk over here a little ways. Again, check just in case, don't wanna die. All right. And I think that's real fun. Real fancy, a lot more fun than the usual obsidian, which is just real kind of dark and scary looking, but I think that's anything but. Okay, let's go back over to the overworld here. And there you go. That's how to change textures inside of Minecraft Bedrock. Make sure you check out my channel for a bunch more Minecraft videos. I got lots of stuff on customizing Minecraft, and I'll see you next time.